हेलो एवरीवन, नमस्ते, वेलकम टू बायो लेक्चर। दिस इज मी डॉक्टर दीपेन, योर होस्ट, एंड वेलकम टू अनदर लेक्चर ऑफ बायोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द नेफ्रॉन। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लिसन केयरफुली, वॉच टिल द लास्ट, राइट इट डाउन, राइट इन इट इन द पेपर। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द नेफ्रॉन डिटेल। वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक इन डिटेल। वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक विथ निमोनिक्स। We are going to make our concept clear of the structural and functional unit of the kidney, that is the nephron. There are approximately 1 to 1.3 million nephron in each kidney. That means, what is 1 million? 10 lakh. So approximately 10 lakh nephrons are there in our each kidney. So there are two kidneys, so approximately about 20 to 25 lakhs nephrons are there in our human kidneys. Now let us talk about the structure of the nephron. This is very important. They may ask you about the structure of the nephron in entrance examination. They may ask you in the plus two examination. So let us talk about the structure of the nephron. This is the schematic diagram. This is the schematic diagram of the nephron. Now this is one nephron. There are millions of nephrons in human kidney. So we are going to talk about only the one nephron. So what is this in the red? This is an arteriole. This is the smaller arteries. So it is called arteriole. This is afferent. This is afferent. This is afferent arteriole. And this is the efferent. Efferent arteriole. This is the afferent. What is afferent and what is efferent? You should know. Afferent means coming inside, coming, going inside, and efferent means exiting, going outside. E for efferent, E for exit, going outside. So afferent means coming inside. Now afferent arteriole come inside this structure. What is this structure? Now this is very important structure. What is this structure? You know, this is the Bowman's capsule. This is the Bowman's capsule. This is BC, Bowman's capsule. So, and what is this structure? These are the capillaries. These are the glomerular capillaries. Now, what is this structure called? Bowman's capsule with glomerular capillaries. What is this structure called? This structure is called the renal corpuscle or the Malpighian body. So this is important. They may ask you, what is Malpighian body? Bowman's capsule plus glomerular capillaries. This is Bowman's capsule. This is glomerular capillaries will form the Malpighian's body. Or the renal corpuscle. So they may ask you, what is renal corpuscle? Bowman's capsule with the glomerular capillaries. Where are the Bowman's capsule present? They may ask you, in the nephron. Where are the glomerular capillaries present? In the nephron. In the Malpighian's body. What is Malpighian's body? Bowman's capsule with glomerular capillaries. BG-mol. Okay, remember BG-mol. B for Bowman's capsule, G for glomerular capillaries or the glomerulus, or you can, this is simply the glomerulus, which is consist of capillaries. So glomerulus, this is Malpighian bodies. MOL stands for Malpighian bodies. You can remember with that. This is the mnemonics. So nephron is consist of two main parts. One is the renal corpuscle or Malpighian's body, and another is the renal tubules. And there are specific tubules. We'll talk about that specific tubules. What is this? This is the proximal convoluted tubule. This is the PCT. And this is what is this called? This is like a loop. What is this called? Loop. This is loop of Henle. So we are going to talk about the tubules, And what is this called? This is DCT. And what is this called? This is the collecting duct. And what is this called? This is the duct of Bellini. This is also important. This is duct of Bellini. Now we'll talk about the tubules. This is proximal convoluted tubules. This is proximal convoluted tubules. Proximal means near the head. Near the head. And here head is the, what is head? Head is the Malfigon's body or the renal corpuscles. Means it is proximal. It is near. So distal means away. It is going away. Okay, distal means away. And loop of Henle is loop-like structure which comes from the PCT, proximal convoluted tubule, and it has mainly two parts. One is the descending part, one is the descending parts, and another is the ascending parts. Another is the ascending part. One is the descending loop of Henle, another is the ascending loop of Henle, and then comes the distal convoluted tubule, and then comes the collecting duct. Then comes the collecting duct, and the collecting ducts form the bigger duct, that is duct of Bellini. Now we'll talk about the histology. Histology means study of the tissues. Study of the tissues. Histology means study of the tissues. Lining. We'll talk about the lining epithelium. Glomerulus lining epithelium is, as glomerulus are the capillaries, their lining epithelium is the endothelium. Is the endothelium. Is the endothelium. So glomerulus endothelium. So what is the lining of the Bowman's capsule? What is the lining of the Bowman's capsule? Do you know? It is squamous. It is the squamous epithelium. It is squamous epithelium. Squamous epithelium. The lining of the Bowman's capsule is the squamous epithelium. And what is the lining of the loop of Henle? Loop of Henle, it is also the squamous epithelium. Squamous epithelium. Loop of Henle is also lined by squamous epithelium. It is lined by squamous epithelium. And the lining of PCT. The lining of PCT is what? This is important. PCT. Proximal convoluted tubule. Lining is what? You should remember. This is, you should remember, it's like a cube, okay, like a cube, and this is, what is this? This is the cuboidal epithelium. This is the cuboidal epithelium. Now, these are, what is this? These are brass, like a brass. So, brass border cuboidal epithelium. Brass border cuboidal epithelium. Proximal convoluted tubule is lined by brass border simple cuboidal epithelium. How do you remember that? This is important. How do you remember? You remember, you are painting the cube with the brass. Paint the cube with brass. Remember, paint the cube with brass. Means paint means PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. Cube means cuboidal, simple cuboidal. Brass means brass border. They may ask you, brass border simple cuboidal epithelium or brass border cuboidal epithelium are present in proximal convoluted tubule. Dear students, now in the structure of the nephron, we'll also talk about how the urine flows now. How the after the glomerular filtration occurs and the filtrate which will become the urine in the future, and how does it pass to the urinary bladder. Okay, we'll talk about the sequence. First of all, we have the glomerulus. We have the glomerulus, and after glomerulus, we have the PCT. Okay, after glomerulus, we have the PCT, proximal convoluted tubule. Then loop of Henle, then the filtrate flows towards the DCT, that is distal convoluted tubule, then into the collecting duct, then into the duct of Bellini, then into the renal pyramids. Then into the renal pyramids. I think you know. Now you know. After renal pyramids, we have already talked in the structure of the kidney. Internal structure of the kidney. We have drawn that figure in our part 1. You can check out that video. The link is in the description below, or you can directly go to my channel and watch the excretory system part 1, the anatomy of the kidney. After renal pyramids, there is renal papilla. Then after renal papilla, there is minor calyces. Approximately 7 to 13 minor calyces are there, and which forms the major calyx. After major calyx, there is a renal pelvis, which becomes the ureter, then the urinary bladder, which finally passes to the urethra and into the environment. Now this is the important sequence that you must know. They may ask you in the multiple choice question, okay, the sequence. That means glomerulus with Bowman's capsule, that is Malpighian body, PCT, loop of Henle, DCT, collecting duct of Bellini, this is important. Then renal pyramids, renal papilla, minor calyces, major calyx, renal pelvis, ureter, bladder, urethra. This is the sequence of the filtration, then the passage of the urine and the concentration of the urine, and finally the excretion of the urine. So last ma chai in garnu bhanda agadi chai ma kidney ko functions, what are the functions of the kidney, tesko bare ma kura garau. Kidney ko main function bhaneko excretion. It is a excretory organ. Immediately unwanted excretory products haru huncha ni, unwanted products haru chai excretion garauncha, jasto ki uric acid haru bhayo, haina urea nai bhayo, tesai gari sodium, potassium, toxic substances, drugs, excess pigments, excretion, unwanted substances, excretion. It is an excretory organ. What is excretory organ? Kidney bike or excretory organ? Lungs. Lungs. Important. Lungs. Kino lungs? Why lungs? It removes excess CO2, carbon dioxide. अर्को भनेको स्किन पनि हो, अर्को भनेको लिभरले टक्सिक सब्सटेन्सेसहरूलाई पनि रिमुभ गर्छ, र अर्को मेनली भनेको सेलिभरी ग्ल्यान्ड्स र इन्टेस्टाइन लार्ज इन्टेस्टाइन भने चाहिँ अरू एक्सक्रेटरी अर्ग्यान्सहरू के हो, स्किन, लिभर, सेलिभरी ग्ल्यान्ड्स र कोलोन, इन्टेस्टाइन. अर्को फंक्शन अफ द किडनी इज द कंट्रोल अफ ब्लड प्रेसर. ब्लड प्रेसरलाई कंट्रोल गर्छ कसरी, फ्लुइडलाई ब्यालेन्स गरेर. र अर्को भनेको इट सेक्रेट्स द इन्जाइम रेनिन, भेरी इम्पोर्टेन्ट इन्जाइम रेनिन, द्याट इज भेरी इम्पोर्टेन्ट. रेनिन इन्जाइम किडनीले सेक्रेट गर्छ, है किडनीको कुन चाहिँ एप्रेटसले सेक्रेट गर्छ भने जेजी एप्रेटस, जक्स्टाग्लोमेरुलस जेजी सेल्सहरूले चाहिँ रेनिन सेक्रेट गर्छ. जक्स्टाग्लोमेरुलर सेल्स द्याट इज प्रेजेन्ट एराउन्ड द ग्लोमेरुलस, है त्यो चाहिँ जेजी सेल्सहरू चाहिँ एराउन्ड द ग्लोमेरुलस हुन्छ, र त्यसले चाहिँ कुन इन्जाइम सेक्रेट गर्छ जेजी सेल्सले, त्यो सुन्न सक्छ रेनिन. रेनिनले के गर्छ, रेनिनको फङ्सन भनेको एन्जियोटेन्सिनोजेन, इट कन्भर्ट्स एन्जियोटेन्सिनोजेन इन्टु एन्जियोटेन्सिन 1, र यो चाहिँ के हो, रेनिन एन्जियोटेन्सिन एल्डोस्टेरोन सिस्टम. यो तपाईँहरूलाई डिटेलमा चाहिँदैन, र रेनिनको फङ्सन चाहिँ सोध्यो भने एन्जियोटेन्सिनोजेन ते एन्जियोटेन्सिन 1 कन्भर्ट गर्छ. र रेनिनको यो अर्को किडनीको फङ्सन भनेको अर्को हर्मोन, इट सेक्रेट्स अ हर्मोन, एथ्रोपोइटिन हर्मोन हो, जसले चाहिँ बोन मेरोमा के प्रड्युस हुन्छ, रेड ब्लड सेल्सहरू प्रड्युस हुन्छ, त्यो स्टिमुलेट प्रड्युस गर्नलाई चाहिँ एर्थ्रोपोइटिनले चाहिँ एकदम प्ले गर्छ, रोल प्ले गर्छ, त्यही भएर किडनीले एर्थ्रोपोइटिन पनि सेक्रेट गर्छ र त्यो एर्थ्रोपोइटिन चाहिँ बोन म्यारोमा गएर चाहिँ काम गर्छ। त्यसले चाहिँ रेड ब्लड सेल्स एर्थ्रोसाइट्सहरूलाई चाहिँ स्टुम प्रड्युस गर्नलाई स्टुमुलेट गर्छ बोन म्यारोमा। सो मोर द एर्थ्रोपोइटिन मोर द आरबिसिज भनेपछि किडनीले चाहिँ, किडनी इज अल्सो कल इन्डोक्राइन ग्ल्यान्ड, किन एर्थ्रोपोइटिन हर्मोन सेक्रेट गर्छ र किडनी इज मेनली द एक्सक्रेटरी अर्ग्यान, त्यो बुझ्नुपर्ने जरुरत छ। टुडे इन आवर सेकेन्ड लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर एन्ड द फङ्सन अफ द नेफ्रोन, वी अल्सो टक्ड अबाउट द फङ्सन अफ द किडनी, वी टक्ड अबाउट द निमोनिक्स। प्लिज ट्युन इन टु आवर च्यानल फर मोर बायो लेक्चर्स, फर मोर भिडियोज रिलेटेड टु बायोलोजी। प्लिज डु सब्सक्राइब, डु हिट द नोटिफिकेसन बेल आइकन, प्लिज डु सेयर सक्दोसम्म तपाईँले सेयर गरिदिनु होला, लाइक पनि गरिदिनु होला। लाइक गऱ्यो भने मलाई मोटिभेसन हुन्छ र यो भिडियोलाई प्रमोट हुनलाई पनि गर्छ र कमेन्ट, प्लिज कमेन्ट डाउन बिलो इफ यु लाइक आवर भिडियो। सी यु गाइज, हेभ अ नाइस डे।